Hey guess waters, are you excited for summer? I know that we are here, and the summer's already hot, but did you know it's not officially summer until the summer solstice? The summer solstice happens every year between June 20th and June 22nd, and this is when the sun reaches its highest altitude in the northern hemisphere. And because the calendar doesn't exactly match the Earth's rotation, the exact time changes somewhat every year. But this makes it the longest day of the year with sunlight that lasts for 17 hours. It's also not uncommon to see people staying out a bit later during this time of the year. And during the summer solstice, it seems that the sun just lingers in the sky for a few days around June 20th to June 22nd. And did you know that astronomers can determine the exact moment of the solstice? But this moment varies from year to year. So even though your calendar might say June 1st is the first day of summer, summer actually begins when the summer solstice happens. You see, meteorologists break the year into four different seasons, which are summer, fall, winter, and spring. And the summer solstice always happens later than the first day of summer that are written on the calendar. The summer solstice begins when the tilt of the Earth's axis is most inclined towards the sun directly above the Tropic of Cancer, and we'll learn more about that in a few minutes. The winter solstice, which is the opposite of the summer solstice, happens around December 20th to 22nd. The winter solstice is the exact opposite of the summer solstice. The winter solstice is when the Earth's axis is tilted furthest away from the sun, marking the beginning of winter. And have you ever wondered why days seem longer during the summer? Well, it's because of the way the Earth revolves around the sun. See, if you live in the northern hemisphere, the half of the world that is north of the equator, then you have the longest days of the year in June, usually again around June 20th to 22nd. And that's the summer solstice. And this is when the tilt of the Earth's axis is most tilted towards the sun, again, directly above the Tropic of Cancer. The winter solstice happens when the Earth's axis is tilted furthest away from the sun. And the greatest tilt towards the sun is 23.44 degrees, which is known as the Tropic of Cancer. In the rest of the year, the Earth's tilt on its axis is approximately 23.5 degrees and causes the sun's path in the sky to rise and fall each day. And the Earth's atmosphere can bend light over the horizon in different amounts. And this also depends on the weather, which, believe it or not, can change the sunrise and sunset times by up to an entire minute. But what happens if you live in the southern hemisphere, you might ask, the other half of the world south of the equator? Well, believe it or not, everything flips. This means that in the southern hemisphere, the longest day of the year is actually December 21st to 22nd. That's why in Australia, you might see some people swimming at the beach during Christmas, and we're in the colder, more wintry weather here. And did you know that the word solstice comes from the Latin words for sun and standing still? And this is because the sun's position in the sky at noon does not look like it changes all that much during the summer solstice and its surrounding days. So now you might be wondering, well, since the summer solstice is the longest day of the year and gets the most sunlight, well, why does it become hotter about a month or two later? Well, that's because of the Earth's water. See, the Earth's surface is covered up mostly by water, and it takes a while to both heat up and cool down. And because of this, Earth's temperature takes several weeks to catch up to the sun. Do you know that many cultures and civilizations have recognized the sun's northern and southern changes for more than 5,000 years? This includes the Egyptians as well as Celts. And did you know that the most popular tradition around the world for the summer solstice is making a bonfire? Why? Well, bonfires are said to honor the fullness of the sun. And bonfires are also created for superstitious reasons, like pushing away evil and mischievous spirits, and also to bring good fortune. and many activities such as singing and dancing around the bonfire continue to this day in many different parts of the world. So if you want to celebrate the summer solstice, think about some things you can do to honor the sun in your part of the world. Also, during the summer solstice, places in the Arctic Circle may only see the sun on the horizon at midnight, and all places north of it will see the sun above the horizon for a full 24 hours a day. Wow. So now you know when it's officially summer. It's not on June 1st. Did you know that already, or did you learn something new from watching this video? If you did, and also like this video, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. And also do me a favor, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and learning with me, and we'll see you on the next Hey, Guess What?